Hi guys, welcome to the new video, and in this video I'll tell you about gaur. Gaur is the largest member of the bovine family. There are three subspecies of gaur that can be found in Nepal and in India, Thailand and Malaysia, from Myanmar to China. Gaur inhabits evergreen and deciduous forests. Great percent of their habitats has been destroyed in the last couple of decades, leading to dramatic decline, 70% in their population of the wild gaurs. Poaching is another factor that affects services. Gaurs are listed as vulnerable species and may become endangered in the near coming future. Interesting facts about gaur. Gaur is the largest representative of the wild cattle. Males weigh about 1,400 and 2,200 pounds. They can reach up to 8 to 11 in length and from 5 to 7 feet at the height at the shoulders. Female can reach only up to 1 by 4 the male size. Body of the gaur is covered with reddish to brown coat. Females and young have lighter coats than the males. Both males and females have upward horns. They can reach up to 45 inches in reach. They are usually green to yellow in color with black tips. Gaurs have deep hollow area of forehead that passes between the horns. Large ears are other prominent features of their head. Gaurs are herbivorous plant eaters. Their diet consists of grass, leaves, shoots and fruits. Gaurs are diurnal animals and active during the day. They are mainly active early in the mornings and late in the afternoon. In areas close to humans, gaur can change their normal routine and become nocturnal animal. Active during the night, it is very rare to see them. Gaurs live in group herd composed of usually 8 to 11 and rarely up to 40. These groups consist of one dominant male and female. During the season, gaurs live in small groups, residing on a smaller altitude during monsoon seasons. Thank you guys for watching the video, and you will subscribe for more. Gaurs are territorial animals, and they can make different types of sound and for communication. High-pitched growling is used for alarm call to inform other members of the group about the upcoming danger. Roaring calls are produced during the mating season. Gaurs are also known for their bad temper. Even a proven gaur can attack and inflict deadly injuries using its horn. Gaurs usually mate from December to June. Dominance between males is determined by their size. The most dominant, the biggest male gets the opportunity to mate with the females in one group. Pregnancy in females lasts 275 days and ends up with only one baby calf. Gaur can survive for 30 days in captivity.